Okay, so today we're going to talk about the best linear approximation of a real valued function of a vector variable. And before we do that, we need to talk about what it means to be a linear function of a vector variable. So let's begin and think about a vector variable a1, a2, blah, 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 a sub n. And we can write that as a1 times 1, 0, blah, 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 0, plus a2 times 0, 1, blah, 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 0, plus and so forth, plus a sub n, 1, 0, 0, blah, 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 1. Better to write that as a1 times e1 plus a2 times e2, plus and so forth, plus a sub n times e sub n, where obviously e sub j is the vector who's got exactly one non-zero entry in the jth row. Now, if we have a linear function, then let's say the function is L, then L of A1, A2, blah, 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 A sub n has got to be equal to A sub 1 times L of E1 plus a sub 2 times L of E2, plus and so forth, plus a sub n times L of En. And as such, the value of the linear function is determined once I tell you these n numbers. So we can say that b sub j is equal to L of e sub j. And then the linear function is L of A1, blah, 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 An is going to be equal to A1, B1, plus A2, B2, plus blah, 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 plus A sub N, Bn. Now that's to say that any linear function can be described in terms of a dot product of our given vector with some fixed vector. So a linear function from Rn into R is determined by a dot product. Now let's look at the calculus case. So we want to consider x to be a vector variable. And we want to consider f of x to be a real valued function. So let's call that w is equal to f of x of a vector variable. And we want to find the best linear approximation for f of x. So to be the best linear approximation means that if we take f at x plus an increment at h, and we subtract the value of f of x from that, then that should be some linear function times h plus some epsilon of h, where epsilon h is small in comparison to h. Now I'd like to be able to divide through by the vector quantity h, but I can't do that, so I'll take the absolute value of h, and then I'll take the limit as h tends to 0 of that, and that should be equal to 0. So in this case, this linear function is applied to h, and for that to be a linear function applied to this vector h, we know what that has to be. That has to be some vectors worth of quantities. So we get f at x plus h minus f at x is equal to some row vector. Let's call it L1, L2, blah, 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 times Ln. And then that's going to be times H1, H2, times blah, 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 Hn, plus epsilon of my vector H. And in order to compute what these coefficients are, we're going to just take vectors in each of our coordinate directions. So if we take f at x plus the vector h 0, 0, blah, 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 0, minus f at the vector x, then that's going to be equal to L1, L2, blah, 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 times Ln, h, 0, blah, 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 0, plus epsilon of h. And so we find out that if we're only moving in the first direction, we get f at x plus h times E1 minus f at x is equal to L times h plus epsilon of h. And that means that L must be equal to the partial of f, L1 must be equal to the partial of f with respect to x1. Now there's nothing special about the coordinate x1, we could do that in any direction. And so we find out that our derivative quantity, L1, L2, blah, 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 Ln, is actually the same as the partial of f with respect to x1, the partial of f with respect to x2, times blah, 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 or so forth, partial of f with respect to xn.